And that there are groups who are seen by many people as presenting a challenge. Some of them do present a challenge, many of them do not. But that these issues, the key thing I would say in all of the integration and identity issues is the tendency of the country that has the migrants coming into it is to try to either give up a little of the native identity or to try to pretend that pluralism is what we are as a society. And I think one of the results of that is that a core part of the culture starts to erode and get lost. And precisely because of that, people feel disproportionately more concerned about incomers than they need to. They feel much more confident if they knew this is what we are, we're not giving this up, this will not change. But they don't, they feel it's all adrift, and that is the dangerous situation I think Europe is heading to.
Well, I think that's also part of the reason why there's a great fear of losing sovereignty to Europe, right? They feel, because people, when someone immigrates from Turkey to Hamburg, right, in Germany, they don't become European, they become German. And yet Germans then feel, well, we're going to give up more of our sovereignty to some supranational organization. And there's a fear there.
But I agree very much on this, because I also think that the point is, as you mentioned, it is neglected for some people in the bubble. And I remind everybody here that the most successful political movement recently in Europe has been the right-wing Soviet Party. They are the ones that win the elections these days. And let me also say that I never hope to get into the situation that Europe should define its identity against somebody else. Because that's very much what we're doing when we look historically.
Thank you. I would like to hear from you. We should join the European Union. And by the way, I think that I proudly can state that we drink more than Scotland, Greece, and Germany all together.
He's your introducer.
From Brussels, the other name, from such an occidental barrier, let's say, a central question. And within this question, can Georgia act a bit on its own to join this Euro-Atlantic space? Maybe starting by NATO, is the way to NATO could be a bit faster than the way to the EU? That is only a question.
As I see it, and goodness knows I'm no expert, I've only been in this country a few days, but as I see it, the main things that Georgia needs, as far as I can see, as much as wants, it would be solved by NATO membership. And I would be, personally, I mean, I thought that would be one of the goals. I say because I'm very aware of the pitfalls that could occur, as well as the advantages of EU membership. But that isn't to say that it shouldn't be something which Georgia looks towards as well. I would simply say that one of the things that may come out of this, and we've heard it recently very often from Brussels, the claim that there cannot be a twin-track or multi-track approach. I suspect that could change. And if it did, there's no reason why Georgia couldn't find one of those tracks that suited it and its needs.
So you would say on security first?
I would say that with everything.
Defense policy, but that's high.
they do economic policy, but that's basically, you know, in Europe, there's very little actually left for a central government. But it is very difficult also to have a united figure. That's about what
I'm saying.
No, but if they split,
yeah.
I think we'll just have another member of the European Union, because none of them want not to be there. Right? That's clear. I was about to say something, but I really don't want to, because there's another liberation issue in Europe that has created a lot of interest, for example, in Catalonia,
yeah.
About following the same discussion. I don't want to mention which one.
The final point.
Just the final point on Belgium. Common point with Belgium and the European Union is the capital, Brussels. And probably in Belgium, what sticks the country together, has a couple sometimes is willing to get separated, but there is a kid.
Yeah.
And then to keep the kid, because they cannot split the kid, so they stay together.
Yeah.
And I suspect that in Belgium, the home of Brussels is central, despite all the tensions.
Well, I think we are approaching on our next panel. So thank you all very much. We learned a couple things. Georgia probably should not race to join the European Union. Scotland is a horrible, terrible place. We should never
go. No, it's good for whiskey.
Thank you all very much.